Flowering rush is a perennial aquatic weed. Native to Europe and Asia, flowering rush was introduced into North America by 1900, possibly both accidentally in ballast and packing material, and intentionally via the horticulture trade. It's still regularly used in horticulture and is readily available for purchase, despite it being illegal in many locations. Flowering rush is now widely naturalized in the states and provinces surrounding the USA-Canada border and is continuing to expand outward. This species is found in freshwater wetlands, lakes, ditches, and slow or fast-moving rivers. It tolerates a wide range of temperatures and occurs from the water's edge up to 20 feet deep. Establishment is promoted by fluctuating water levels, and dammed water bodies often make ideal habitat. Flowering rush displaces native plant species, impedes water flow, damages fishing, boating, swimming, and other recreational sectors, and provides habitat for predatory fish species that feed on native trout and salmon. From March to May, flowering rush leaves begin growing from rhizomes. Some leaves emerge from the water. These are rigid, triangular in cross-section, and can grow upright, typically to 3 feet tall. When growing in deeper water, submerged leaves are up to 10 feet long and are often limp, flowing with a current. All leaves have parallel veins and are twisted at their tips. Flower stalks are round in cross-section, erect, and typically about 3 feet tall. No leaves occur on flowering stems. Flowering typically occurs from June through September, depending on location. Flowers occur in umbels that resemble upside-down umbrellas, with all flower stems arising from a single point. Each cluster has 20 to 50 light pink flowers with red or purple veins. Each flower is approximately 1 inch in diameter, with 3 petals, 3 sepals that resemble petals, and 9 stamens. Some forms of the plant are capable of producing thousands of seeds that remain viable for many years, while other forms are sterile. In addition, many forms of the plant produce hundreds of small buds on rhizomes, and some also produce 1 to 24 bulbils in the flower umbels. Rhizome buds and bulbils are small, bulb-like structures that can grow into new plants. They are readily dislodged, greatly aiding the spread of flowering rush. All plants have brittle rhizomes that readily break following minor disturbances from waves, passing boats, and waterfowl. Fragments disperse easily on water currents to start new populations elsewhere. Despite sometimes high seed production, the majority of flowering rush spread is through rhizome fragments and buds. The plant dies back to its rhizomes for winter and re-sprouts the following spring from its rhizomes. Before it flowers, flowering rush resembles several species in the Northwest, including cattails, true rushes, and sedges. Cattails are similar with their round flowering stems, but their leaves are flat in cross-section. True rushes are also similar with their round flowering stems, but they don't have triangular leaves. Sedges differ by having triangular flowering stems. Cattails, true rushes, and sedges all have non-showy brown flowers. Swamp milkweed and spotted Joe pieweed resemble flowering rush with their large clusters of pink flowers, but they differ by having smaller leaves growing off their stems rather than directly from rhizomes.